wouldn't it be interesting for you to know how 100 kilos of biodegradable waste could be downsized to 5 kilos with a living organism that is available in nature in a very short time with not much smell, which is very simple and which is low cost? Why is this composting such an important aspect? The reason is because if we look around, we find that we have heaps and heaps of garbage, all created by us humans, from our homes, from our offices, from our institutions, from our markets, meat markets, fish market, vegetable market, flower markets, and all these heaps can have this simple solution for its garbage problems. How did I come about finding out this unique way of composting? Being a lover of nature and passionate about doing something for nature, I started 3 projects consecutively at Carmel's. One was to teach students about segregation. The wet waste that was collected was composted, and the compost that was obtained was used for an organic vegetable garden, one feeding the other. The composting unit was called as K2K, Kitchen Kachra to Compost. And it was kept outside my biology laboratory, close to the library. The composting went on very well. But after a few months, I was amazed to see some worms that were crawling out of the bin and moving along the walls, and it was a disturbance to the students and the staff. So I received complaints to say that there is this weird looking worm that is coming out of the bin. So I had a solution for it. I took a basin of water and placed the composting bin inside the basin so that the worms would not move out. But my keen observation and the background of biology made me feel that this particular worm that I was seeing must be a larvae of some insect. My curiosity took over, and I collected a few of these worms, put them in a glass jar, and kept them under observation. Observed it day after day with a lot of patience. And after a few weeks, lo and behold, there was this insect that emerged out. When I looked at it, I was a little confused. Well, is it a housefly? But it didn't look so. So I investigated. I went through books. I went through the net. And I found that this particular insect was none other than black soldier fly. The zoological name for it is Hermatia illucens. When I read more about it, I found out that the larvae is a detrivore. And it is this larvae that can convert and biodegrade and downsize the biodegradable waste into very useful components. When I found this, it coincided with the time when my daughter, Zuleika, was chosen by her school to represent the state for a science project organized by SCRT. There was a lot of brainstorming as to what topic is to be chosen. So under the topic of environment, we took this composting unit. And we researched. She did a lot of hard work, a lot of study, many units which were failed. And finally, after a lot of research and failing, we succeeded in designing a new unit for this composting. Later on, she won the first prize at the state level. She was invited to represent the state at the national level. There, out of 900 participants, she won the first place and a gold medal. Later on, she won the Child Excellence Award for Innovation, and that was the President's Award. I now call my daughter Zuleika to tell you more about the unit and to show you how it works.
I believe that Mother Nature has the answers to most of our problems. All we need to do is be aware and observant enough to look, listen, and realize that she is hiding the solutions to all our problems in plain sight. Now, you may have heard of different types of composting methods like aerobic, anaerobic, using EM or effective microorganisms, and vermicomposting. These have their own limitations. But we have a superhero that will crush this villain that is garbage. It is the BSF, or the black soldier fly, and its larvae. So what makes this unit and this method of composting so impressive? What gives it the one-up over all other methods of composting? Let us see. In hermicomposting, as we're calling it, you can use any type of biodegradable waste, be it meats, oils, anything very acidic or basic. Whereas in vermicomposting, you can't. You can use only plant material. That too, it can't be anything oily, it can't be anything too acidic, as in you can't use tomatoes and lime. And you can't use anything too basic either. In hermicomposting, you don't get much smell, whereas in vermicomposting you do, because you need to add cow dung to the composting pit, which gives out methane, which is a greenhouse gas, and also other greenhouse gases. Whereas in hermicomposting, you get only minuscule amounts of carbon dioxide, which we give out. In hermicomposting, the worms, the detrivore that is used is very hardy and true to its name, a soldier fly. It is strong, hardy, and can work well even in adverse conditions. Whereas in vermicomposting, the worms that are used, that is the earthworms, they are very delicate and need to be treated like tiny babies, need to be pampered with the right amount of moisture and the right pH. Also, if they are attacked by ants, they can die. Whereas the BSF larvae, it doesn't happen with them. In vermicomposting also, you need to take care that it is not attacked frequently by pest insects like houseflies. This adds to the smell. Whereas in hermicomposting, you don't have to worry about that, because in an established colony of larvae, they give out pheromones which keep away other insect pests. In hermicomposting, the downsizing capability is very large. It can downsize a large amount of waste, as we saw in the beginning, to a very small amount in a short period of time. You don't need any hi-fi technology, and you don't need any special education. So let us see what value-added products are that can be found in this unit, which can't be got anywhere else. You have the solid compost that is formed here in this bin. It can be used as manure for your plants, or it can be sold for a profit. This container here collects all the liquid leachate that comes out of the compost, as in any composting. It can be diluted and used again as manure for plants because it is very rich in nitrates. The larvae, prepupae and pupae, they harvest themselves into this container here. They can be used as feed for fowls, for animals, or they can be sold off for people who want to start their own composting units. And the thing about these larvae is that if you have some composting material, say meat or anything else, you will find these worms, definitely, because they are easily available in the tropics. And as you know, India is in the tropics. Or they can be just added, if they're too many, then they can just be added to soil somewhere because they will enrich the nutrients in the soil. The pheromones, as I said earlier, are given out by the larvae in an established colony, and they will prevent pests and houseflies to come to this unit. And also the pupal exoskeleton that is given out during the molting process, as we will see later, that is rich in proteins and has various uses also. Now we need to know that garbage is a change of state. And using this unit, we can change the state of garbage. We can change it from something toxic and unsafe to something safe and give it back to Mother Nature. Speaking of mothers, I would like to call upon my mother to explain in detail the life cycle of this amazing, unassuming insect.
Life cycle of Hermesia illucens. It starts off with the male and female insects. They have a one-point agenda in life, and that is to mate and to reproduce. The reason is because their bodies already have the food that they have collected during the vociferous feeding. This food allows them to live from 5 to 8 days because that is the lifespan of the insect. They do not have any mouth parts and therefore they do not feed. So after they mate, the female looks for a place where there is enough of food for the growing larvae, and it will not lay the eggs in the compost, but it will lay the eggs somewhere above so that when the eggs hatch out, they fall into the biodegradable waste. So that is what is given in this unit. The insects enter from these sides, and below inside there is a place with corrugated cardboard which has crevices inside which it will lay the eggs. The eggs hatch out, and the larvae that fall into the bin, which already is provided with biodegradable waste. Now, if you weigh, one hatching would be equal to about 1 gram of larvae. What is so amazing is that if you have provided enough of biodegradable waste, they eat or they feed upon it voraciously, and they grow up to become about 2.5 kilos of larvae, which are rich in protein, they are rich in calcium, they are rich in fat and other minerals. Now, these larvae, from the first stage to the fifth stage, they go through 5 molds. They are called as 5 instars. And before they become the larvae, they have a stage which is called as the pre-pupae. What is to be noted in this pre-pupae stage is that they lose their mouth parts. They bring about a change in their internal structure, and the mouth part is now converted into an appendage with the help of which it can move. And it is at this time that the larvae, which is in the pre-pupae stage, would like to move out of this biocomposting pit and move out to a dry, cozy, warm place. And that is what we have designed, where the larvae moves out and now comes into this container. When it falls into this container, it moves into the next stage, and that is an immovable stage, and that is the pupae. This pupae, if you look at it, it is a small black structure which is hard, and you have to wait for 21 days where this immovable structure is going on with metamorphosis within. The contents change into the body of an insect. And after 21 days, the pupae opens up, and here comes the insect. This insect is released by opening up this knob. The insect comes out back again into the atmosphere or into the environment. And another characteristic of this insect is that wherever it has been hatched, it comes back again to that place. It has a strong sense of smell. So wherever there is any composting going on, if not at the same place, it goes and starts with its life cycle again. So this unit is created after having learnt the details about the nature, the likes, and the way by which this larvae goes about with its life cycle. And this entire unit is self-sustaining. All you have to do is get your biodegradable waste and put it in, and you get all the benefits that Mother Nature gives it to you. And your problem about garbage is solved by downsizing your garbage and giving you value-based products. This unit can be used as an integrated unit, whereby it can be used in agricultural farms, in animal farms, where every product can be used and recycled. As I said earlier, I mistook it for a housefly. And we always know that the housefly is a pest carrying diseases. But you can see that there is a difference between the housefly and hermesia. The difference is in the mouth parts. The housefly mouth parts have a proboscis, with the help of which it feeds from the surrounding substances. And with that, it may carry some germs. And when it goes and stays on any other food, etc., it will pass on the germs there. Whereas hermesia does not have any mouth parts. Secondly, if you look at the appendages, you will find that there are padded appendages for the housefly, so that those padded appendages will be able to collect the germs. And that is how it transfers. Whereas hermesia does not have those padded appendages. Therefore, we find that hermesia has so many positive aspects which everyone can use it for biocomposting.
So we see how Mother Nature is truly a loving, caring and nurturing mother who provides us with everything that we need to live and survive. So why not do our part to help Mother Nature and help make this world a cleaner, greener and less smelly place? I hope you are impressed with this tiny, unassuming creature and will do all you can to at least start to try and solve the garbage problem. Thank you.
Thank you.